Are you tired of annoying ads and want to simplify your life? Stick around, and in just a few minutes, we will have your Synology NAS running AdGuard with Docker, and you will be surfing ad-free in no time. Hey there, welcome back to my channel. Before we dive in, remember to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of my tech-savvy and hilariously entertaining content. Not today, I'm going to talk about Docker and why it's the bee's knees for running applications. With Docker, you can isolate applications for enhanced security and performance, share and deploy applications quickly and easily, and enjoy a consistent environment across systems. Trust me, you will be thanking me for Docker making your life much easier. Now, should you be using Docker on your Synology NAS? Well, simple, you should. It will maximize your hardware resources by being able to run multiple server applications on one physical server, and they are very easy to manage and update. By the way, if you haven't smashed that subscribe button yet, give it a gentle tap with your favorite finger. We promise not to judge your choice. So, all right, let's get Docker installed on your Synology NAS. Just follow these steps. Log in to DSM, your Synology Disk Station Manager, through your Synology NAS IP. Open Package Center, search for Docker, and then click Install, and basically wait for the process to complete. That's it. You're now a proud owner of Docker on your Synology NAS. Time to set up AdGuard and say goodbye to those pesky ads. Here's how. Launch Docker from the Synology NAS main menu. Click on Registry and search for AdGuard. Select the official AdGuard image and click Download. After downloading, go to Image and click Launch to create a new container. On the Network section, you can choose Use the same network as Docker host in case you don't have any other application using a bunch of ports such as 443 on the NAS. I personally prefer to have these applications behind a NAT, so I will choose Bridge. Name your container, and now you can choose Enable Resource Limitation in case you'd like to limit how much CPU and memory this container can take. I generally start at a low CPU priority and 256 MB of RAM, and later on I change that in case it's needed. Now click Next. This part is very important. You can leave all ports on auto, but both ports 53, you will need to type 53 under local port. This is because that's the port used by computers to communicate to DNS servers. The other port you might want to specify a local port number is port 3000. If you don't have any other application using that port, go ahead and type 3000 on both fields. This is the port that you use to manage AdGuard on the web browser. Click Next, and now we will add our configuration folder. Click Add Folder, choose the Docker shared folder, and then click on Create Folder. Name it AdGuard. Then click on the AdGuard folder and create two other folders in it, Config and Data. Now add both folders, and for the Config folder, under Mount Path, you will write /opt/AdGuardHome/conf for config. And for the data folder, you will write /opt/AdGuardHome/work. What are these folders for? Well, they are the folders for persistent data. Whenever you need to update the container, you will basically delete the container. The configuration files will continue to exist in these folders, and then you will get an updated image and create a new container pointing again to these folders. This also makes it easy to backup the configurations of your Docker containers by backing up the Docker shared folder. Now, click Next, and then done. Congratulations! You have successfully installed AdGuard using Docker on your Synology NAS. By the way, if you're still here and haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Click that subscribe button like you're playing a game of whack-a-mole. Just don't break your screen, okay? Now, you have installed AdGuard. Let's walk through the configuration process to get it up and running. Just follow these simple steps. Access AdGuard's web interface by visiting the IP address of your Synology NAS, followed by the number that the port number that you assigned during the configuration. So I was using port 3000, so 192.168.1.100.3000. Okay, you'll be graded by the AdGuard Setup Wizard. First, select your preferred language and click Get Started. Under Admin Web Interface, Listen Interface, set the port to 3000, then click Next. Add your username and password, and then click Next. And then now you can click on Open Dashboard. And now you're gonna log in with the username and password that you just set up. Now we need to configure the upstream DNSs for AdGuard. Now we're gonna go click on Settings and then DNS settings. Now you can paste the DNS for Google and Cloudflare that I have in the description, and then you scroll down and click on Test Upstreams. Once you get a green, then click on Apply. Now the next step is to identify your DNS block lists. You can go into Filters and DNS block lists and then add as many of the filters as you want, test them as you may. AdGuard offers a variety of filter options, including privacy protection, ad blocking, and parental control. I use everything except parental control. Now, update the DNS settings on your devices or router to point to the IP address of your NAS. This will ensure that all your network traffic passes through AdGuard, providing ad-free browsing. And that's it. You've successfully configured AdGuard using Docker on your Synology NAS. Enjoy a cleaner, faster, and more secure browsing experience. In case you missed any of my previous reminders, go ahead and hit that subscribe button with the enthusiasm of someone that just discovered ad-free browsing. We'd love to have you join our community. So, there you have it. You're now an expert in setting up Docker and AdGuard on your Synology NAS. Remember, this is just the beginning. We will have many more videos coming soon about Docker, Synology, and in particular the changes from Docker to Container Manager on the upcoming DSM 7.2. So stay tuned because you don't want to miss it. And one last time, I promise, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and keep up with the latest tips, tricks, and workflows. Your support means a lot to me. Catch you in the next video. Bye-bye.